Dear students, class, today we are going to start with our next part of HTML. That is the second part. In first part, you have learned about the formatting, bold, italic, underline, and you have learned about the different type of headings, paragraph, font. So all this you have studied. Now class, we will move on to our next topic, very important. That is HTML second part, image, forms, audio and video. Class, for this you have to go with your computer only class. In mobile it is very difficult to do this image, forms. A form still you can do, but images, inserting an images and audio video, these are very difficult things to do because we need an address, and for address in mobile it is not available that much clearly. So let's move forward. So class, inserting images is our first topic. Images class, here a special tag is formed that we call a img, and img tag use src, this is the source, and with the help of these two, this is the tag and this is the attribute of it. With the help of these two we can insert the images, but we are having different attributes also to work with. So class, this is the page in which it is told that images that you insert should be of GIF, that is graphic interface format, or JPEG, that is joint photographic expert group. These two type of images, and one more is there, JPJ, PNG, that can also be inserted in this. So class, your next is image src, this is the syntax. Under that src, and here is the URL. URL means here you have to write the address of the image that is uniquely defined in your computer. Now class, one example how to insert an image. So for that, this you know very well, HTML, head, title, head, body, yellow color they have given as a BG color, body is close and HTML close. Here is just a heading they have given, and finally the important thing is this image src, rows.jpg, but this is not a complete address in your computer. It is somewhere in C drive or D drive. Under that you have made a folder. So class, for that I have told you previously also, you open that image with the help of Internet Explorer, and from there you copy the address and here you paste it. That is the best method to insert an image. So class, this is one thing, and the output of this particular is this inserted image was the heading that they have written, and this is the image. Now here the image size is not specified. We can give the image size also, it will come as according to the computer format, but if you want to resize it you can give. Next is your alignment is very important. Suppose you want to align in a different part of your web page. So for that, bottom, top, left, middle and right are the options. Align, in place of this alignment you have to write this top, bottom, left, middle or right. Next is they have set an example. This example you will do, and after this doing this complete example, you will see your web page like this. So class, for that image should be there. So you download some images for your computer, and not exactly these images, you can use any images. This is just an example. So your class, your next is alter. This attribute contains the alter text for an image. It appears on the web page if the image does not appear on the web page due to some reason. So class, if your image is not coming, then this text will appear in that. So as they have used, you can see that in altar they have written it is a national flower. It is a national flower. So in place of image, this is coming. So you can give that also. Now, as I've told you, we can resize it. We can give the height and the width of it. So height and the width can be specified using the width and height. It is can be given in pixels. It can be given in percentage. So class, you see this example. It is little bit blur, it is coming, but still you can see that it is given 100, this, and alignment is given left, and the image source is this. So after that, you will find the output like this. Left we have given, so it is coming in left, and rest of the things are coming as it is. So class, let's move to our next topic. Next topic is very important, class. This question often come in your board examination. How to write this A2? How to write this B2? So this is a subscript. SUB is a tag name that you can give before and after this 2. Then this 2 will appear down. Similarly, SUP, if you want to write A square, you want to write B square. In that condition, this 2 you have to write within this SUP tag. So you see this example, the chemical equation they have given C plus O sub 2. So 2 will come down, and here equals to CO2. This 2 will come down in a subscript as you write in chemistry. Now in mathematics, you write the formula A plus B whole square. So A plus B whole square, the square will come with the help of this SUB, is equals to A square. 2 will come appear at as a power, and here also as a power, and plus 2AB. Now you can see that how it is coming. So this is the output. So that's all, class. This much you have to go with and do it practically and make some short note of it and send it to me. That's all, class.